Hey guys, I'd like to ask you the $64,000 question. Who the hell are you? You know, I've been thinking about that question for a little bit of time now. It was only a week ago, or actually 2 weeks ago now, that one of my patients passed away, and it really got me thinking. Her name was Pat, by the way, and she watched all my videos, all the messages that I put out there, and it really had a profound impact on her as a person. And maybe 3 months ago, during our intermittent routine together, she said to me, "Hey, I want to share something with you." I'm like, "What's going on?" She said, "I was just diagnosed with liver cancer, and it spread to my colon, and it's not looking good. But I'll tell you something," she said to me. "I'm gonna fight like crazy, and I'm gonna keep coming here because I like it here. I really enjoy you, and you complete me on some level." And of course, I was blown away by that. And that's when I just really started thinking about, who am I? Why is she wanting to spend time with me? You know, it was just a few weeks ago, she came in like 3 days prior to her death, and she looked pretty bad. Her body was giving up, and although she hadn't given up, her body was really ravaged by that point, and she was struggling. So, when I got the call that she had passed away, it was her nephew, and her nephew said to me and my wife, we worked together, he said that she really loved you guys, and that she appreciated everything that you did for her, and how much love and compassion that you showed to her. And that was pretty powerful to me. That left me kind of stunned. Especially where it was really down the last few hours of her life that she wanted to make sure that she told her nephew to deliver that message to me from beyond. Wow. What a humbling, humbling experience. And in between thinking about what her and I had together, I was still thinking about my next video, about my business, about working with other corporate environments, thinking about my kids, thinking about retirement. All these things were in my head, which is in all of our heads, and there's nothing wrong with that. But eventually, at some point, you have to step back and realize that even though those are still important integers in our lives, the most important thing comes down to who are you and how will you impact somebody else's life. I was also watching just Well, today I watched it again because I couldn't help myself. But I watched this America's Got Talent. This young man, Michael Ketterer. He is a pediatric mental health nurse. He helps young. I don't know if I should call him nurse or therapist. Sorry, Mike. However I said it. But he helps young children with their struggles. Whether it's bullying or they have a sickness or a disease. He's an incredible young man, and he adopted three little boys, him and his wife, who they had had their own child, but it was a close call that mom and child were not expected to live, but they did. And then he adopted three little kids that were struggling. Then he adopted another child who was also struggling. And his last adoption was a young boy with cerebral palsy who he had a great opportunity to work with and was blessed to have that opportunity to bring him home and provide him with a home, which is really cool. And then he goes on to America's Got Talent, and he sings about, not about it, but what he's singing about is really connected to his story. And it moves people, move me tremendously, and I know it will move you too. And not for nothing, I put a link in the down below in the description for you to click on it. It's another YouTube video. Just watch it if you get a chance. It'll move you. It has to. If it doesn't move you, then you're probably already dead. So anyway, while I was sitting and listening to him and listening to his story, it got rid of everything in my life that was bothering me and plaguing me and making me overthink. It just brought me to who I am. And in that moment, I really realized who I am and why I am. And that is that I truly just wanted to care for people and take care of everybody that I could because I want to ease suffering in the world. I don't know why I'm built this way. I could give you a lot of reasons, and that would surely be for another show. But Michael gave me an opportunity to reconnect with the person that I am. Not what I do for work, not who I married, not all these things of the living world which we can compare ourselves to someone else, but simply just to feel who I am in that moment. And if you watch that video that below Michael singing, somewhere in the first few minutes, there's a young woman. She appears to be in her early 20s. And she's looking up in wonder. And you'll see her face. And I can't do it, but imagine this. She's just kind of transfixed on what he's singing. And you can tell that he's having a significant impact upon her and her emotional system. Take a good look at her face, too. She's definitely just wanting to come out of her skin. And you can feel that emotion, and he brought it. He didn't try to bring the emotion, he just brought himself, that he's a loving caregiver, and that's it. So the question is for each one of us, who the hell are you? Well, let me tell you something interesting that I've also learned, is that part of who we are is our ego, and our ego is really powerful. Ego is there to protect us and to validate us to the world that we belong here. I'm not saying it's wrong, because there's no person on this planet that isn't driven by ego on some level. Some people bring it to the red line and some people keep it kind of mild. But I'm telling you that your ego can become a problem. You can be so caught up in your own ego to define to the world who you are that you begin to measure who you are based upon what people see in you. In other words, what kind of car do you drive? How much money do you own? Are you divorced? Are you single? All these things that we pit ourselves with is just basically us trying to keep up with the world and trying to feed our ego like it's an engine that needs gasoline. When in reality, it's best at some point to step back away from the ego and allow yourself to be exposed for just who you are. And that's what Michael did on that video. Very, very powerful. And it's okay to be just who you are. And when you think that all these other people have it all going on and you don't, you're wrong. People suffer all the time. Matters not who they are, what they've created, how much wealth they have, if they're on TV or they're doing a YouTube channel. None of that matters. At the end of the day, when a person is ill and someone's dying, that thing all goes away, which somehow crushes our ego and brings us right back to who we are as people. And who are you? Have you asked yourself that question? Have you put yourself in positions to let the ego go and not worry about what the world thinks of you? Rather just experience an emotional moment in your life in order to feel. You know, somebody recently asked me and they said, hey Pete, what do you think the meaning of life is? And I pondered this for a long time. My interpretation of the meaning in life is actually quite simple. It's to feel. I simply just want to feel. I want to feel everything, just like a child. They want to touch everything, touch, feel. They want to smell everything. They want to smell flowers. They want to eat birthday cake. They want to splash in the water. They want to get their feet dirty and their new sneakers muddy. Because all they really want to do is experience the world through how they feel. And they want to feel amazing. And I know you want to feel great too. The question is, will you allow yourself to feel great? Will you allow yourself to feel like the authentic you inside? Or will you simply live the egotistical mantra and worry about what people think of you? Will you spend most of your time building wealth, building relationships that favor you? I mean, was it you to go out and to prove to the world that you belong here? Or will that proof be in the pudding just by being the person that you truly are? Well, I certainly hope it's B. I hope at some point you're able to step away for a moment just by watching that America's Got Talent video. Is that enough? Of course, it's enough for the moment. In that moment, I started to realize just how special Michael is as a person. And even though he's not asking for anything, the man that he is, the loving, compassionate, giving man, is actually receiving now as the golden buzzer goes off and all the little confetti drops and the world now knows who he is. Will that feed his ego? It will, if he lets it. But could he also continue his message? that young children need help. They need our love. They need our compassion. They need our time and our understanding. And they need us to be model citizens so that they can then have something to emulate. Yes, I believe that's true. So at some point this week, I want you to think about who you are and how you want to feel. Sometimes in those painful moments in life, you start to realize that our ego is probably lying to us. Yes, we have it. Yes, it protects us. But to what extent? To hurt us, to hurt others around us, to leave us stuck in the comfort zone where nothing grows? Is that where you want to be? I don't know. It's not where I want to be, though. I'll tell you that right now. I am a confident, young, professional man. And at times, that can work against me. My ego can get too big, and then I become argumentative, opinionated, and trying to prove to everybody that I'm right. I don't think that works for me. Unfortunately, at times, I have to be reminded of this, and thank God for shows like America's Got Talent and for performers like Michael Ketterer, who made me see something in myself that was taking a back seat. Make sure that love and compassion is the thing that fuels you, and that you go out and you help someone else. And in those moments of joy and connection with people, that'll be the true currency of success. And that's what I got for you today. I want to say a special shout out to my friend Cassie, one of my patients. I had a great conversation with her, with you, Cassie, the other day. Thank you. I appreciate that. I also appreciate Robin. I appreciate her husband, Todd. I appreciate all of you out there who are watching. If I didn't have an audience, there'd be nobody to talk to. So I appreciate you and thank you for following me. Also, I want to make one last shout out to my buddy, the Bald Adonis. Mike, I've been really busy lately. So many things going on, so I apologize that I've been kind of missing for a bit, but hang in there, buddy. We'll get back together again soon. So if you get a chance, if you feel like it's appropriate, go ahead and subscribe and leave any comments down below. It's the dialogue that really helps to extend these conversations. So I wish you the very best this week. Have yourself a wonderful, wonderful time with your friends and family.